చిన్నగా Hello. Yeah, a very good evening to everyone. I hope you can all hear me. Hey, hi Radhika. And hi Harshad. So yep, so let's get started now over here. So, like yesterday, so I will request all of you to please open that file that we were using yesterday onto the part of the one that we were using for the banking data. So please, all of you, open that file. Okay. See, now I will request all of you to please create a chart, right? So like if you remember yesterday, we did an age analysis where we were able to see how many people are there between the age of 15 to 19, 20 to 24, likewise. Now, can you create a similar chart for balance analysis as well? So all of you, please create a chart on this, a balance analysis. Yep, I hope you are trying it. So a histogram for balance analysis.
Hey, so I've made a histogram with the age and balance. So the bin...
Only the balance. We just need only balance. Right? So I want to see, does the bank have more customers with low balance or the bank has more customers with high balance? Like in this case, we can see more customers are in the middle age.
Yeah, 30-35.
Similarly, we want to see the similarities for balance also. Like for example, what I do now is if I come over here into a new sheet, so what I'll be doing over here is first of all, we had to convert the age into a dimension, and I have to do the same thing for the balance. Now see, balance is something which is very wide, right? Like age is something that will be between 0 to 100. It won't go beyond 100 over here. But now balance is something, it could be, someone could have low balance as $100 and another person can have $1 million, right? So the range of balance is very, very high. So let's try to create it. If I pick this up and put age balance into the column, so you see we have lots of balance, that is why this method, this warning is coming. and then I see that I put the count. So we can see there are 4012 marks. That means there are 4012 bars. One customer is having $11, another customer is having 69. Then, you know, we have 69.78, right, 21. So we can see most of the balances are unique. Every person is having a unique balance in his account. And that, and oh, there is a balance for which there are two customers also. I can see there are two customers for this particular balance. But right now this balance, this chart is of no use. Since we have to create a histogram, so what I'll do is I'll right click on this and I will say create a bin, right? I'll be getting bins over here. Now, if you see over here, Tableau automatically suggests the bin size. Now, over this time over here, last time, if you remember in the age analysis at that over there, what was happening was Tableau was suggesting a bin size of, I guess, 3.92. Now it is suggesting a bin size of 3,977, like almost 4,000. Because balance is something big. I can't keep a bin size of 5 over here, right? How many are having $0 to $5, $5 to $10, $10 to $15, because that will give me lots of bars. So Tableau is suggesting me a bigger size. So that size is around 3,977. So what I can do is I can probably keep it the size as 4,000, right? Maybe 5,000, that would be a better way. Let's keep the bin size of 5,000 and click OK. And now my balance bin is created. Let's replace it. So we can see there are 324 customers between 0 to 5,000, 5 to 10,000, 10 to 15,000. Likewise, so as the balance is increasing, the number of customers are decreasing. I hope you are able to get this. Okay, so shall I move ahead? See, now you know on this chart that we have created, now we are going to learn a very important functionality of the Tableau. And that is something that is called as parameters. Okay, see, first of all, I would like to tell you what exactly a parameter is. Parameters is the functionality by which the end user, or I would say customer, can give some input values. Right, so parameter is the functionality in which what happens is the customer or the end user, they can give some input values, right? Based on which the chart will change. Just give me one more. Okay, so now this is basically, it's a functionality wherein what happens is the end user can give some value.
Yeah.
So basically what I want to do is basically, you know, I want to get a functionality where the end user can give some input values, right? So for what do I mean by that is, see, what is the bin size in this chart right now? What is the bin size? The bin size right now in this chart is 5,000, right? So we have kept the bin size of 5,000. Now what I want is that, you know, I want to give the user, right, the person who will be consuming this report, what should happen is he should get some, you know, a parameter over here where if he says that, you know, I don't want to see the bin size of 5,000, I want to see the bin size of 10,000. I want to see how the chart will look like in that case. Or probably he feels that I would like to see the bin size of 7,000 or 8,000. So, you know, he wants to change the bin size by himself when he is analyzing this report. So this feature is something that is given by the help of parameters. Right now, parameter can be used for lots and lots of purposes. So like, for example, we will be using parameter, like, you know, you can create a chart where suppose you want to showcase top selling products, right? A person can select whether he wants to see top 5 selling products, top 6 selling products, top 10 selling products. So the end user will be able to decide how many top products does he wants to see. Okay, they will be able to select that. So that is where, again, the parameters are used. So let's see how do we create the parameter. Okay, in order to create the parameter, there are three steps that you have to follow. First of all, create the parameter. Then show the parameter. And then finally, assign the parameter. Now, these are some of the steps that we have to take care of while we are working or while we are creating the parameter. Now, how do you create a parameter? Let's start with it. Click on this little arrow. You will find the option of create parameter. You will find this option in multiple places. See, you can right click over here. You will find that create parameter. You can click over here. You will find the option of create parameter. You can right click on any of the field also. Over there also, you will find create parameter. Right? So you can create the parameter from multiple places. So I'll click over here and I'll say create parameter. Now we give this parameter a name. Let us call it as balance bin parameter. Now, you know, if you name this parameter now, so what we need to do over here is, it is asking for the data type. What type of data do you want the user can enter in that, right? So definitely for bin, a person will only enter an integer value, right? So I'm saying integer, right? Then you can just, this is just the formatting option that will come. So the main options that we have over here is, they are these three, okay? Now, this is an option which says allowable values. What all values do you want the user to enter, right? So now if I come over here, I say all. All means a user can put anything. A user can put any value, whatever value he wants. Okay, so let me show you. So first of all, please, all of you put these things. Put the values like this. Okay, so if you click on OK, right click and say show parameter. So you will see the parameter will be visible over here. Here the parameter is visible over here. Now you can put any number over here, right? You can see you can put 100, you can put 500, you can put any number. So if you see over here, we have done two of the steps. So parameter is created and we have shown the parameter. Now what I need to do over here is I need to assign the parameter, right? Basically what is happening is this parameter is not changing the value. The chart is not changing. If I'm putting any value over here, the chart is not changing because this value that I'm putting, this value has to go inside this chart, right? Then only the chart will change. And that is where this assignment is required. So when I say assignment, where will this value be assigned? So I have to make sure that this value 500 is assigned in the balance bin. Because right now in this balance bin, what is the value? That is 5000. I want that whatever value I put over here, that value gets assigned over here. Now, if that value will be assigned over here, then this chart is going to change according to that, right? This is how the structure is going to happen, flow, right? I hope all of you are with me. Anyone, any doubt up till here?
Can you repeat that one?
Like basically what we're doing is,
Amit, I can't hear you.
Amit, your voice is inaudible. Can't hear you.
Hello. Yeah, hi. Sorry, guys. Actually, there is a power failure that just happened. So I was explaining this. See, basically what we have done is we have created a parameter, right? Now, this is like a user box. A person can put any value inside this, right? This is like just a user input box.
That is to change the size of the bin according to the like client use.
So this is something that I've given as an input where a person can put number. This is something like a bin size, right? Suppose I put 6,000. This is, I'm trying to say that I want to have a bin size of 6,000. Okay. But the chart has not changed right now. Yes. And the reason for that is because this is just an input value. I'm just putting the value, but this value is right now not assigned over here. And how will it be assigned? Now, because this chart will change if the value changes over here in the balance bin, if I edit this, because over there the value is 5,000. If I make it 6,000, the chart will change, right? The chart change according to that, 0 to 6,000, 6 to 12,000. So I want that whatever value I put over here, that should impact this chart. And that how will that impact? If I come over here and if I edit it, now over here that this value is hard coded. I have put it up as a hard code value. But if I come over here, if you click on the drop down, you will start seeing the parameter name. This parameter that I have created, I can see that name. So now I am saying the size of the bin depends upon whatever value I have in the balance bin parameter. So if I have 6,000 over here, I am saying that I want the bin size of 6,000. If person puts 7,000, that means I am saying I want a bin size of 7,000. So now if I click OK, now let's change, play with the chart. If I put 10,000, the chart change. I put 12,000, the chart change. I put 5,000, the chart change. Now is it making sense?
Yes. Amit, one question. So right, we created a parameter using one of the input values, which is used in the chart. That is balance bin. We're using balance bin. Use a parameter of measure which is not being used in the sheet.
Sorry, we can have.
Can we make a parameter of a measure which is in the data source but not being used in the sheet? Like, let's say, for example, customer ID.
I got like, how do you want to use it? I mean, I don't get
so, it. Okay. So basically what I'm saying that we are using to make this histogram, we have used balance bin and we have used count. So when we change the balance bin parameter, it changes the chart accordingly.
Correct. But
if, can we make a parameter out of any of the other measures like gender, job classification, name, region, which is not present in the sheet right now, which is neither in the column or the rows, can we make a parameter out of it?
You can do that. I show you. So if you, I mean, so you are saying you want to make a parameter for a column that is not present in your data, right?
It is present in the data source, but it is not present in the sheet. In this sheet.
In the, you can do that. See, the parameter that you create, it is like something that will be used across all the files. See, if I go into any other sheet also, the parameter is still visible. So I can use this parameter on this sheet also and on this sheet also.
Okay. Okay. That's all. Because I have used Tableau a little bit and I used to use it to, so now I'm understanding it more because there used to be parameters like these on those sheets. And they had work package IDs and I used to just search for work package ID. They did not used to show it initially in the sheet, but as soon as I entered that exact work package ID, it used to populate all the information about that work package. So that is the same kind of thing over here also.
Okay. No, I'll be doing a lot more examples also on this to understand it better because it has lots of use cases. So we'll be seeing that. Okay. So can you all do this? Can you apply the same functionality for this chart also? Now please create a parameter for a chart as well and assign it. Okay. See, now if I come over here, the way you would have done it is you would have again created a new parameter, right? I'll call it as H parameter and the value will be again integer. Okay. See, now you all would have used the value as all. Now this time I'm going to use list. See, in the list, what happens is, as the name tells, you can give list of values. See, in the all, what happens is, right, when you are working with the all, right? So when you work with all, a person can put any value, but when you are working with list, in the list, you can give the value that he can put either 5, 7, 9, and 10. Now you are saying that the person can only enter these values. He cannot enter any value outside this range. If I click on OK, you can see parameter is created. Let me say show parameter. So parameter is visible over here, right? So now what I'm going to do in this chart is I am going to assign this parameter for this chart. So where will I do it? I have the age bin. I'll say edit this. And over here, I'm going to assign the age parameter. And there we go. Now if I select 5, 7, 9, 10, so chart will change according to that.
Amit, do we have to always create a bin first for assigning the parameter?
You have to create the.
We have to. Do we have to create a bin always before assigning the parameter?
So because this is the bin value only that we are putting over here, right? So that is why the bin has to be there if you are using it for bin.
Okay, but what about for normal charts? What about for normal chart?
So see, parameter is something which we use for giving some input, right? Now, like for example, in this case, what we are doing is we are changing the bin size. Okay. Now, suppose I come over here. Let me show you a small example. Say, suppose you know I create a chart over here. Let me create another chart. Say, suppose I am showing I have the product names. And I have the sales value. So these are all the products that I'm selling. Now I am selling 1850 products. In the chart, I only want to showcase top 5 products. So what I can do is, so if I bring the product name over here in the filters, I have a fixture of top. I am saying I want to showcase only top 5 by sales. I only want to showcase top 5 products. Right now the chart is showing me only the top 5 selling products. Now parameters come into the use when we want to give the flexibility to the end user. Now this chart has got fixed that it will always give only top 5 products. But I now my customer says I want to see top 7 products or top 10 products. So that is where again I'll have to create a parameter. Right. So what I will do is I will create the parameter over here. So parameter is a utility where the end user can give some, you know, input. So now where the filter was applied, I'll go over there and in the top, I will assign that parameter. Okay. So now see what happens is only top 1 product. If I write top 10, it will give me top 10 products. If I write 20, it will give me top 20 products. So okay. It totally depends upon how you want to use it.
Right. Okay.
So now in the same parameter, right? So if I edit the parameter now, I was using the option of list. Similarly, you have an option of range. Now range is also something like this. In this, you are saying a person can put a minimum value of 5, maximum value of, suppose I say 15. Step size means how the values are going to jump. So I'm saying 5 and the value should jump by 2. So that is 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. Okay, that is called as step size. So you can give the user an option of all where a person can put anything, or you can give him a list, or you can give him a range.
Can we give him a
Hello? Plus, I hope you all can hear me.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Okay. So now, you know, I'm going to do in this. So is this part of the parameters clear to all of you?
I have a doubt. Like in the starting, we created with all, right?
Yes.
And I assigned it to the measure also. Then later you told us to change it to the list. I changed it, but it is not updating. How I have to do that?
Not updating. Basically, in the list for the age parameter, right? You're asking for this?
Yes, yes.
So in the list, what you do is you have to give the values.
Yeah, I did that. Yes.
So that's it. If you will come over here on this, you will now get the list over here.
I am not getting that list. It was giving me the like all option only.
You can change the style, right? You can just click on this. Okay. From here, you have the three options. You can make it single value list or you can make it compact. That's just a view.
Okay. Just by updating in the parameter, it will automatically assign it to the previous assignment, right? I don't have to reassign or delete anything.
No. That you don't have to do anything.
Okay.
So now, so this is what we have as an age analysis. Now, you know, you can also do a very interesting thing. You can make your titles also dynamic. See, because in this case, you see age analysis. I want to say in the header, I want to write bin size is equal to. I'm saying bin size is equal to. So whatever value a person puts over here, the person should be able to select the, you know, basically what should happen is in that chart, the bin size should change according to that. Okay, suppose if I say if a person puts a bin size of 5, so the bin size should change automatically to 5 over here. If a person puts 7, it should change to 7. So I'm going to say insert parameter. So you see over here in the title box, there is an option of insert. In the insert, you can say insert age parameter. So whatever is the value of each parameter, I am putting that inside this. Now what will happen is, see, I say if I select 7, min size equal to 7, 9. So I can make my titles a little dynamic with that. Are you able to do it? Okay. Now let's add another sheet inside it. We'll add a main sheet. Now over here, what we want to achieve over here is, I would like to see, you know, I would like to create a chart where I would like to see analysis by job classification. Right, customer count by job classification. Okay, customer count by job classification. So can you all create a chart first? Just create a bar chart for this particular analysis. Just create a bar chart now. Done. So simple. It's basically we have to use the job classification, and I have to use the count, and the chart is ready. But what we are going to do over here is, if I click on the show me, there is a chart called as bubble chart. We will convert this chart into bubble chart now. Right. So bubble chart is something like this. Bigger the bubble, higher the count. Smaller bubble, smaller count. Okay, so this is a bubble. So just a different representation, right? Just a different representation, but analysis that we are getting is the same. So now you see we have created 5 charts. Now I'll request all of you to please create a dashboard out of it. Make a nice dashboard out of it and save it as a Tableau public.
Ahmed, I lost all my charts because my system just hanged and closed Tableau.
Okay.
So I'll create them again. But what can you please show the last one again, bubble chart, how you made it?
This one?
Yes.
So we just did what I did was, I made a chart for job classification. and I had put up a count, which gave me a bar chart. Then I clicked on show me, and I get a pivot into a bubble chart.
So, okay, we can show the count and label also inside the bubble.
Yeah, you can do that. Click on the count and put in a label.
Okay. And the question I was asking earlier was that can we use customer ID as a parameter? Like to enter. Like if you go, there was one of the charts, like where you created parameter one.
You want to add, you want to put customer ID as a parameter, right?
Yes.
You can do it, right click on this, create parameter. So you get all the customer IDs now inside this. So you have all the customer IDs, you click on OK.
The value is like numerical, right?
Sorry?
The value is like numerical. So is that okay?
Because that only depends if the data is numerical, so you it has created up an integer. If the data was character, you can change it to string also, character also, you can do that as well.
There are commas, right? But when someone will enter the value of custom ID, they won't put commas.
See, first of all, you have to understand that, you know, parameter is something that the user gives.
Yes.
How do you want to use this parameter? Like, if suppose a customer gives a customer ID, how do you want to choose that? How do you want to be utilized?
As it is, like whatever the customer ID is without the comma.
No. My question is, like, I give you a parameter. Okay, now I have this parameter over here. Now a person can select any customer ID from here.
Oh.
But how do you want this customer ID to impact the chart? How do you want to utilize this customer ID on your chart?
Right, not this particular chart. But so in any particular chart, let's say we create a dashboard and we put all the values and we put our different analysis. So as we put a customer ID for a particular customer, if we want to see the analysis for a high net worth individual or someone,
then we can
see it.
So this is how you can use it. So a person can select the customer ID instead of typing it up, because the customer ID is really big. So it's better you give him a list. You can select any customer ID from here, and based on that, the chart will show the analysis for that particular customer ID.
Okay. And such files which have parameters, what is the preferable mode of saving them, like TWB or TWBX?
You can save it in any one of them, TWB or TWBX. So, because parameter is the property of the tableau, so in both the files, this parameter will be saved inside this file only.
Okay. So even in TWB, when the data is not saved, all the customer IDs as a list will show up to anybody?
No, in that case, what has happened is that the customer ID is coming from the column.
Hmm.
So when the data will be loaded, then the customer ID will be loaded inside it. But when you are creating a balance parameter, right, like this, in this, the value was something that I had inserted by myself. This was the user. All means the person who put anything. Now, in this, the value is coming from the user only. When you say a list, in the list, what I did was I was giving my own values, that, you know, 5, 10, 15, 20. So these values are saved inside the file. But when the values are coming from some column, so the moment the data will be loaded, right away the parameter will also get updated.
Okay. Sorted. Thanks.
Amit, can we assign the parameter to entire workbook like filters?
No, not in one go.
Okay.
The parameter will be assigned to every chart. Are you looking at a dashboard? Okay. So if you bring the chart, so let me increase the size of this. Size is fine, we can have a little more width. So now what I will do over here is I will do some formatting, right? If you see on this side, we have all the legends and the parameters. See this, do you think this legend is required? The male and female.
I think no because right? It's already in the chart.
Yeah, it's already in the chart. Nobody is going to come and see. So what I can do is I can remove this. I will say delete this. Same is the thing for this legend also, blue color, other and white color. It is already in the chart. I can remove this. Okay, this is the age parameter. So customer, you know, this is not required. I was just showing you an example on this. Now, typically I'm left with only two parameters. And let me close this also. This is just a number. So now, you know, in Tableau, there is one feature, right? If you will see over here, you can create the dashboards in two ways, by two methods. One is called as tiled, another is called as floating, right? These are two techniques in which the dashboard can be created. So by default, it is tiled. Okay, in the tiled, what happens is you place the chart, they will automatically be adjusted. But if I add a new dashboard and if I make it in a floating way, in the floating, what happens is you will bring the chart. You will have to adjust each and everything by yourself. Right? This is more like a time-taking process. You will have to, you know, decide what you want to keep, how you want to keep, where you want to keep. You can keep on doing that. So either you can go create the dashboard in the tiled view or in the floating view. But as a best practice, you should create enough tiled view. Okay. Now you can also convert any chart into floating. Like for example, this is the parameter. Okay. Let me change its type. Let me make it a compact list. And what I can do is I can make it floating. Right. So if you click on this little arrow, you can make it floating. In the floating, what will happen now is you will be able to move it wherever you want. So I'll keep it near the age chart and balance parameter also. I'll make it floating and I'll keep it near the balance chart. Please try this out.
Amit, we just removed those gender and these age parameters and all these from the right side, right? On the dashboard. If you want to include them back, how do you do?
I mean, you want to take them back over there only?
No. We just removed three of them, right? Other than the parameters. So how do we get them back into
legend,
the dashboard?
The legend, if you want them back, see, we removed the legend of this chart.
Yes.
Right? So click on this arrow. Mm-hmm. You will find the option of legend. If you want to bring that color legend, so it is back.
Okay. Thank you.
Now you can all, you know, we can put up a dashboard title also at the top. We can put a title like this. Suppose I want to call it as the UK bank report. Okay, so I'll apply this. Let's make it bold. Okay. You can apply some background color. Now you can also apply a logo. So what you can do is you can all try to download a small image. So you can download a logo of a bank. Suppose I say UK bank. So I can download any UK bank, right? So Bank of England, let's download this. Download any image, and if you come to the report back, you just have to click over here at the bottom on the image. Double click on this image, you can choose that image. Fit image, center image, apply, and okay. So please bring the image. Then what I can do is I can make this image floating. And I'll put the logo at the top. Right, so I have the logo of my bank also over here. And if I bring it in the full screen, so this is how the final report looks like. No, I need to make some adjustments over here. If you see, this parameter is coming correct, this parameter is not coming correct, and the title are also not in the same line. So we need to make something appropriate with this chart, right? Because the physical, you know, aesthetics also play an important role. how it's coming in the same line. Okay. Do you think you can add some more feature on this? Anything extra you can add on this?
Maybe a website link.
Sorry?
Maybe a website link for the bank.
Okay, we can do that. We can add a website link if you want.
A location parameter.
Which parameter?
Location, like if we can choose the state province.
So for that, if we can make it a action filter, right? If I make this an action filter, so the only thing it will add a lot more interactiveness. If I select Scotland, so complete analysis for Scotland. If I select England, complete analysis for England. If I select Ireland, complete analysis for Ireland. Right?
Amit, how to add the website link?
Sorry?
How to add the website link?
So you want to add this over here only? If you just come over here.
Anywhere, maybe.
You can just put the target over here on the image itself. So you can put that image link. Okay, you just put the title over here, and if you click or someone will click on that image.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, shall we move ahead? So, you know, before we move ahead now, so I would like to understand that any question you would like to ask on that exercise? Did you all get a chance to work on that assignment that I shared?
I did, but I didn't complete it fully. Maybe by this weekend I'll be able to.
Okay. I know today also, today what I'll do is I'll be giving you an additional assignment as well, which you all will work over the weekend. So what you can do is you can all save this file. So I will just click on save. Now, you know, there is one feature what I would like to tell you over here, which is not something you will be using just because it's a feature we have in the Tableau. We should know about it, right? So there is a feature in the Tableau which is called a storytelling. Okay, you also have it, right? In the Tableau public also you have it. See, when you click on this, you add a sheet. When you click on this, you add a dashboard. And when you click on this, this is a feature of adding a storytelling. Okay, if you will click on this icon over here right now, this is going to add a new story feature in this. Okay. Now, story feature is nothing. It's like, you know, suppose you have to give a presentation somewhere. Okay. If you want to give some presentation somewhere. So what you can do is you can use this platform to do that. See, in this, what you do is, see, in the dashboard, what you were able to do was, you were dragging the sheets. In the story, you can drag a sheet or a dashboard, but you can only drag one thing at one time. Suppose I drag sheet one. I am saying, I write something over here. England has highest number of customers. Okay. Then what I do is I add a blank page. Over here, I add another sheet. I say male customers are more. I add third sheet, blank sheet. Now I add third sheet over here. Most customers are in the age group of 30 to 40. So I can keep on dragging my sheets and I can keep on writing my captions, right? So this is just like a platform if I want to give some presentation, right? So I can make it full screen and I can just keep on moving between the charts if I want to give some presentation somewhere, right? So you can give this storyline also. If you double click on this, you can call it as UK bank story.
Amit, can I share my screen? I'm having some issue with the placement of dashboard.
Oh, sure.
Are you able to see my screen?
Yes.
So, okay, I'll remove this. First and then... So this is the dashboard. So now sheet one over here. Now I don't see an option of like fixing the height or like.
Is there a size? No.
Where?
What size? What size do you want to fix?
I just want to make it at this end, like left hand, top left hand.
No, you will have to drag the another sheet. So by default, this sheet one will take the entire space.
Okay, so it is stacking up like this now. This is coming on
top. So what you have to do is you have to see. Remove it, click on cross sign of the gender. Yeah, remove it. Now, when you bring the second sheet, select the sheet two, click on it, keep the click, don't release the click, right? And just hover on the dashboard. Bring it and hover on the dashboard. So you have to select that place. That how do you want to drag it?
Okay. Okay, now it's coming at the bottom. But I wanted on the time, so...
Just give me a second. Can you give me the controls once?
Yeah, 1 second. Yeah.
I know you just added something over here on this. See. You bring the sheet one. Okay. Now you bring the sheet two over here. You just see, you just have to hover it. Where do you want to place it?
Okay.
So if I place it at the bottom, it comes over here. So now try it again. Let me delete it. Now try this again once.
remove this extra?
Sorry?
How do I remove this extra?
Actually, while removing something, you have clicked somewhere. That is why that selection is coming not properly.
Played out.
The reason that it's coming out, you had clicked somewhere.
Yeah, when I was removing the job classification, it was white color was selected in.
So that is where you have made a small. Can you press Control Z? Just undo the things once. Just undo it. See, wait. So that this blue color was clicked. Click on that blue color. Blue color. Huh.
Okay.
Yeah. Now delete that.
Background color.
Click on the top format. Top format dashboard. So you will now get shading option on the left side. The first one only, yes. Dashboard shading. And you know this job classification chart that you have, click on the job classification, make it entire view. At the top you see it is standard, make it entire view, so it will come in the middle. Yeah. So now you know what I'm going to do is I'm just sharing this one file with all of you, okay, on the WhatsApp. So let me just do it. So allow me to download this file, one Excel file I have shared on the WhatsApp. Okay, see now you can see over here, you know, in this Excel file that I've shared with you, there are three sheets inside it. List of orders, order breakdown, and sales target. So I just want all of you to please, you know, spend 1 minute in order to understand what do we have in the files. Okay. So if you will see in this file, what we have is in the list of orders, you have the list of orders that were sold, right? This order ID was sold on this date, which was purchased by this customer from this country, state, and city, right? And if you come to the second sheet, you have a breakup of that order, right? You have the breakup that in a particular order, what were the products that the customer purchased, right? Like, for example, in this case, the customer purchased 3 products, and you can see that values and everything over here. Then you have a sales target. In this, you have some monthly targets that are created, right? Like, for example, for the month of Jan, for furniture, this was the target in terms of sales. For Feb, this is the target. For March, this is the target. So we have written the targets for all the months over here. Okay. Now, suppose right now what I will do is let's just ignore the sales target, right? Just ignore the sales target for a second. What we are going to see over here right now is, suppose I want to create a chart where I want to see how much sale happened across the different countries. So how will I do it? How will I get it? Suppose I want to see how much sales happened in Sweden, France, and Italy. How will I get it?
We'll connect the 2 sheets.
On what basis?
Order ID.
Order ID, yeah. Right? So you'll have to, because country names are in this and sales value is in this, right? So we'll have to, first of all, join these 2 data sets on the basis of order ID. So, you know, you can join the data sets in the Tableau as well, right? So let's open a new Tableau file. Okay, we will connect to the data. That is amazing, Matt. You can just watch for a minute, then you can all try it. So I want to join these 2 sheets together, list of orders and order breakdown. Okay, so how do we do it? You bring the list of orders. Now you have all the data of list of orders. Double click on this and now bring order breakdown over here. And right away you will notice Tableau creates a join. What type of a join is it? This is an inner join. If you click on this join, it tells you that this is an inner join that Tableau has created. If you want to convert it into a left join, right join, or full join, you can do that. And at the bottom, Tableau has also showed you that it has created a join on the basis of order ID, because order ID was something that was common between the 2 data sets. So Tableau was smart enough to identify that. Okay. Now you can notice the data is ready. You have all the fields coming over here. Now you can create your chart the way you want. So you want to do a regional analysis, pick up the country. All the countries will come up. You want to show the sales, pick up the sales and put in the size. The chart is ready. Okay. So please try it at your end. So I think, you know, this is where we'll take a pause for today, right? So we'll take a pause.
over here. And yep, so we'll be starting with a new topic tomorrow, that is data blending, which is way more important topic, and we'll need some introduction. So that is where we'll start. So anything you would like to ask before we move ahead? Okay. Okay guys, so thank you. So let's connect tomorrow. And I'll share one more assignment with you in the meantime, so on which you can all work upon, maybe today or over the weekend, and we can discuss on that as well. Any class? Okay, thank you guys. So, have a pleasant evening. See you all tomorrow.